Hi viewers, I hope you all are doing well. So this is our second video, cancer biology. Let's start it. Tumor suppressor genes हमने पढ़ लिया था. Next we discussed about what is the molecular basis of cancer. Cancer is a genetic disease. Mutations in genes result in altered proteins like during cell division, external agents, random event. Most cancers result from mutations in somatic cells. Some cancers are caused by mutations in germline cells. Theories of cancer genes are standard dogma, proto-oncogenes, res melanoma, tumor suppressor genes. This one, tumor suppressor genes. So standard modified dogma is mutation in a DNA repair gene leads to the accumulation of unrepaired mutations. Early stability through theory. Master genes required for adequate cell reproductions are disabled, resulting in aneuploidy. Normal cells, the body is made up of billions of cells that can only be seen under a microscope. These cells are ground together to make up the tissues and organs of the bodies. In normal tissues, the rates of the new growth and old death are kept in balance. If the cell growth loss of control, there will be leading to cancer. Next slide, benign and malignant tumors. Tumors, lumps can be benign, not cancer, or malignant. Benign tumors are usually grow quite slowly. Second one, do not separate to other parts of the body. Third one is usually having a covering that is made up of normal cells. Benign tumors are made up of cells that are quite similar to normal cells. They will only cause a problem if they grow very large, become uncomfortable or unsightly, press on other body organs, are taking up space inside the skull, release hormones that affect how the body functions. Malignant tumors are made up of cancer cells. They usually, first one is usually grow faster than benign tumors. Second one is separate through and destroy surrounding tissues. Third one is separate to the other parts of the body as show in the figure. There is a diagram in this slide. Malignant versus benign tumors. Benign, not cancer tumor cells grow only locally and cannot separate by invasion or metastasis. Malignant cancer cells invade a neighboring tissues, enter blood vessels and muster cells to different sites. Malignant versus benign tumors. Benign tumors generally do not separate by invasion or metastasis. Malignant tumors are capable of separating by invasion and metastasis. Primary and secondary cancer. The place where cancer begins is called the primary cancer, but the cancer cells can separate. They can break away and are carried in the blood or lymphatic system to other parts of the body. There they can start to grow new tumors. Cancer can also separate to nearby body tissues. For example, lung cancer can separate to the limiting of the chest, the pleura. Ovarian cancers can separate to the lining of the abdomen, the peritoneum. Tumors from cancer that have separated are called second cancer. Doctors sometimes call these areas of cancer separate metastasis. They may say a cancer that has a separate has metastasized. Mechanism of cancer separate. Cancers are capable of separating throughout the body by two mechanisms: invasion, metastasis. Invasion refers to the direct migration and penetration by cancer cells into a neighboring tissues. Metastasis refers the ability of cancers cells to penetrate into a lymphatic and blood vessels, circulate through the bloodstream and the invade normal tissues everywhere in the body. So this is second part of the video. I hope you like this video. Next slide we'll discuss in third part of the video. So take care. Bye.